kinsay maka-feel sa gugma sa Ginoo. Amen. No, despite sa daghang problema sa life, I don't know about you, pero I believe God is good. Amen. Maayo kaayo ang Ginoo. Dili gyud nato na siya maski, 'di ba, sa giingon na kaganina nga wala na lang siya nakamata, and kana pa lang alone, kumakain ko nga, Lord, are you really faithful to me? Maayo ba jud ka sa ako ang Ginoo? Ngano din ako mabati? I tell you, dili sa tanang higayon, not all the time, nga pagkamaayo sa Ginoo ayahang faithfulness sa iya, yung panalangin sa imuha, not all the time nga imo siyang ma-feel. Mo agree mo, ana? Dili sa tanang panahon mabati nimo ang Ginoo. But one thing is for sure, ang pulong sa Ginoo, the word of God will stand. Amen. Magbarog jud na siya. And mo na ang reason karon nga naa ako dinhi, it's because of the goodness of God's word nga iyang gibutang sa akong kasing-kasing na grabing bagyo uno sa kinabuhi. Name it. But ang ako lang yung maingon is it's because tungod kay nagagunit jud ko sa pulong sa Ginoo, maski magkalisod-lisod, bahalag Lord, magkaramot sing Lord, bahalag magkadasmag-dasmag, but still anak ko Lord, dili jud ko nimo Ginoo pasagdan. You are my shepherd, you're gonna lead me all the way. Amen. So dapat ing ana ta sa Ginoo. Amen. Let's not be ashamed na mutawag sa Ginoo, Lord, maghilom na lang ko Lord. Uy, no, God wants us to speak, say something, amen? Because that's the only way na imo pong ma-share imong heart sa Ginoo. Lord, I'm not okay. And God understands that, amen? So let's speak atong ablihan, atong mga baba, whatever that's in your heart, siguro na-worry ka, na-balaka, just speak, amen? Sige, so atong ablihan ang atong mga Bible sa Unang Samuel. Sige, kinsay gusto mo basa? 1 Samuel 3.
Now the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord in the presence of Eli. And the word of the Lord was rare in those days. There was no frequent vision. At that time, Eli, whose eyesight had begun to grow dim so that he could not see, was lying down in his own place. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called Samuel, and he said, "Here I am," and ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call you, lie down again." So he went lay down. And the Lord called again, "Samuel." And Samuel arose and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call you, my son, lay down again." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. And the Lord called Samuel again the third time. And he arose and he went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore Eli said to Samuel, "Go lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant hears.'" So Samuel went lay down in his place. And the Lord came and stood, calling us at other times, "Samuel, Samuel." And Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant hears." Then the Lord said to Samuel, "Behold, I am about to do a thing in Israel at which two ears of everyone who hears it will tingle. On that day I will fulfill against Eli all that I have spoken concerning his house, from beginning to end. And I declare to him that I am about to punish his house forever for the iniquity that he knew, because his sons were blaspheming God, and he did not restrain them. Therefore, I swear to the house of Eli that the iniquity of Eli's house shall be atoned for by sacrifice or offering forever." Samuel lay until morning. Then he opened the doors of the house of the Lord, and Samuel was afraid to tell the vision to Eli. But Eli called Samuel and said, "Samuel, my son." And he said, "Here I am." And Eli said, "What was it that the Lord told you? Do not hide it from me. My God do so to you, and more also if you hide anything from me of all that he told you." So Samuel told him him everything and hid nothing from him, and he said, "It is the Lord. Let him do what seems good to him." And Samuel grew, and the Lord was with him, and let none of his words fall to the ground. And all Israel from Dan to Beersheba knew that Samuel was established as a prophet of the Lord. And the Lord appeared again at Shiloh, for the Lord revealed himself to Samuel at Shiloh by the word of the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Salamat, Anna. Sige. Thank you, Lord. So ato ning ano, mag-study ta karon sa life ni Samuel. So din hi atong makita na unsa man, it took Samuel 4 times nga kanang sige siya tubag sa Ginoo. First gitawag siya sa Ginoo, ikaduha, ikatulo, hangtod ikaupat gitawag siya sa Ginoo. And this time ang iyang response, unsa nagani, in siya nga speak, in siya speak for your servant is listening. First, second, third time sige niya mapagkamalan, it was Eli calling him. But at the fourth time giignan Eli helped him, gitabangan na siya ni Eli, ingon siya nga it's the Lord that's, you know, calling your name. So this is how you answer him. Speak, Lord, I'm gonna listen to you. So imagine ninyo, no, ikaupat gyud siyang tawag sa Ginoo. Pero makita ninyo na every time God would speak to him, Samuel, Samuel, bangon dayon siya. Imagine mo, it says here, bata pa siya. No, pero abti kay siya, every time God calls him, ingon na siya, yes, yes, ana siya, mutupag yun siya. So I believe he was being trained na kani bitong na train lang siya nga mutubag siya directly. Ana gud, and I'm amazed nga sa kabata pa niya ing ani na siya mo respond sa high priest. And then verse 11 to 14. Unsa man atong makita danha sa verse 11 to 14? Sige daw, Jeanette, please. Unsa na giingon danha? Verse 11. Okay, so danha, sige, danha na sa verse 11 to 14, God started to talk to Samuel. Sa higayon, sa time nga niingon na si Samuel na, yes, Lord, speak, I'm gonna listen. And that's the time the Lord, unsa man, nag-download na siya, ano sa iyaha, gigisturyahan na siya, ngayong ani, Eli is not, you know, his sons are not really walking, you know, uprightly, and I'm gonna punish this, you know, kaya dili gyud siya mag-tolerate og sala. So God has spoken to Samuel everything, gidetalye niya, nga unsa ang gibuhat sa mga anak ni Eli. And then, unsa may nahitabo? So basically, God was talking to him, ginasturya lang siya. And then, ma-imagine na ako, bata as you are, you know, here in the middle of the night, I believe nga, all of a sudden, nagsturya ang Ginoo sa iyo. Nya, deep pagid kay nga mga words. Oh, sige daw, Net. Siya ang giingon.
Behold, I am about to do a thing in Israel at which the two ears of everyone who hears it will tingle. On that day, I will fulfill against Eli all that I have spoken concerning his house from beginning to end.
True. Tapos, pagka verse, kung mo, ano ta, padayon ta, verse 15 to 18, after God spoke to Samuel, kinsa na po yung istorya kay Samuel? Si Eli na po. Ingon po, ingon na si Eli nga, Samuel, unsa mag-iingon ni Lord sa imuha? Just say everything. So, bata as you are, I believe ni istorya lang po siya, though nag-ingon dito nga, nakatulog, mag-isag tarong, no? Pero naingon siya nga, speak, Eli said to him, speak everything, tell me, unsa giingon ni Lord sa imuha. So if I was, you know, if I were Samuel, bata as I am, moingon jud ko nga, Lord, napasupo man ko ani Lord, unsa man ako nasugdan Lord. First si Lord nga nag-download siya information kay Samuel, and then the following day si Eli na po, ang high priest, nag-istorya na po siya kay Samuel. So bata as you are, parang okay, diba? Unsa man ang usually nga response sa bata, they cannot really grasp ani nga mga deep na mga butang. But during that time, the only thing nga gibuhat ni Samuel was unsa man? Listening. Naminaw lang siya. Diba? Maayo nga counselor ni si Samuel. And then, verse 19 to 20. I don't know what happened, pero after dinhi, kuingo siyang basaho, nagingo na dinhi nga, the Lord was with Samuel. All Israel recognized Samuel and attested or proven him to be what? To be the prophet of the Lord. Dili prophet of somebody else, but the prophet of the Lord. Imagine the tanan, all Israel recognized him. Nga kani propeta gyud na sa Ginoo. So karon ang akong topic would be hearing and obeying the Lord's voice. Amen. Okay lang ba mo ana? Thank you, Lord. Sige, so why do we need to hear and obey the voice of the Lord? So number one, okay, only by hearing can we increase our faith in God. Amen. No other way. I don't know sa imuhang pamaagi, pero the only way na mag-increase ang imong pagtuo is through hearing the word. Dili sa giingon ni Nathan nga opinion, dili sa mga assumption ni Reverend Vidal, but it's gonna be the word of the Lord only. Amen? So, inagingon din he sa Romans 10:17. So, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by what? Hearing by the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Pila sa inyo ha gusto mag-increase ang inyong pagtuo? Nganong kailangan mo increase ang atong pagtuo? Why? Because it's the only thing that will please the Lord. Wala na ilain. If you have faith, then kana naagi panalangin si Lord. Pero kung wala kay faith, how can God moves? So it's through faith, pinaagi lang yun sa ato ang pagtuo diha kang Ginoong Hesus makabaton taog unsa man mga pag-increase or naay ka ng abundance nga faith or abundance nga unsa man pagsalig nga kinabuhi. Yes. So again, remember that Romans 10:17, pinaagi lang gyud sa pagpaminaw. Okay? Kinsay naminaw karon? Kinsay naa din he, pero ang gipaminaw di ay kay FMDI or unsa ba kaha? Sige, go. Sige, number two. Katawa si Jorda, ka-relate si Jorda. Sige, number two. Your life will span a great deal of time. Amen. Who would want to have long life? Sa tanan nga mo agree nga gusto silang taas nga kinabuhi, mayingon og?
Amen.
So, kung gusto ka makabaton og long life, if you wanna live a long life, you don't have to go to Belo and injection all the things that needs to be injected in your body just for you to have long life. The Bible says, unsa man, just hear my word. Just increase your faith in me. Pinaagi sa imong pagpaminaw sa akong pulong, I'm gonna give you long life. Amen? Dili kay mo adto mangita, adto ka mag-search ka sa Google kung unsa bagay makapadugay sa akong kinabuhi. Ah, kani sigurong stem cell or kani sigurong... No! It's only by the word of God. Kung imong itamod or kung imong sundon ang pulong sa Ginoo, that's the only way nga mo taas ang imong kinabuhi. Amen? Sige, ato sa ning basahon, Proverbs 4:10. Hear my son and accept my sayings and the years of your life will be many. Amen? Salamat Lord sa kinabuhi nga daghan. Amen? Dili daghan nga, giklone ka, pero daghan nga katuigan. Meaning, daghang birthdays to come and daghang candles to blow. Amen? Because that's the promise of the Lord. Happy birthday sa mga nai birthday. Woo! Amen. Thank you, Jesus. So, number three, we are able to discern the difference between right and wrong. 1 John 4:6, nagingod din he, we are from God. Unsa daw? We are from? And he who knows God listens to us. Hala, lingaw lagi ni. He who is not from God does not listen to us. So mga igsuon, kung naa ka sa Ginoo and then people doesn't listen to you, unsa man ang giingon dinhi? Grabe no, seryoso kay si Lord. Ingon din siya, he who is not from God does not listen to us. By this we know the spirit of truth and the spirit of unsa man, error. So the more we need, the more we listen and the more we obey God's word, naanatay capability or naanatay abilidad, naanatay kagahom nga unsa man mo discern sa mga butang, either this is good or this is bad. Tama? Dili na kamingon nga halok, kalunod sa manso ni Lord, dili na kamawerla. Why? Because naanakay discernment. Muna maingon silang, ay, naka-discern dyan kung adili ni maayo. Okay? So, kung naay mo ingon sa imuha nga, Ate Jeanette, magminyo, nagyud ko, kay giigna na dyan ko ni Lord, o niya, second year high school pa siya. Diba? Do you think it's right or wrong? Wrong, kay dili pa man siya tama na panahon. Okay? So, makadiscern ta sa mga butang. Example lang na siya. Makadiscern ka unsa ang maayo sa dautan, pinaagi sa imong kanunay nga pagpaminaw sa pulong sa Ginoo. So, ako ning basahon ha. The Lord consistently speaks to us and directs our steps. It's not that the Lord isn't speaking, it's that we are not listening. Kinsay mo agree ana? So constantly si Lord nagasturya dai siya miko, hala seryoso na gyud nagasturya giday si Lord. I would say yes. Ang problema lang tagahan kitag madunggan nga mga voices around us. Mot nang dili kita makadungog sa tingog sa Ginoo. Okay, most people do not listen with a desire to understand. They listen with the intention to reply. How many of us nga naagi mo storya, wa pagani? Di ba naagi mga tao nga, ilahatan ang storya? Di ba na po yung mga tao nga maminaw lang? No? Asa man mo, ana? So, nagingon din nga daghan, kasagaran sa mga tao, ano lang sila, kanang storya lang, pero usually dili gid nila na sabtan. Mao nang naingon nga wala gid nimo na sabtan akong gusto ipaabot. Why? Because wala pa gani na human, apa gani sa one half reply nila dili so wala na kay panahon nga maminaw, kay wala pa gani na human nitubag na dayon ka. So this time let's try to kanang ano, let's try to help ourselves na kung tabian kay ka o dahan kay kag maingon, that's good, pero let's practice na okay, maminaw ko sa ani nga sitwasyon and then let me reply later on ug unsa ba gid ang gusto ipaabot. Okay, so unsa man ang mga okay, number 4 pa di ay tama na ba? God can provide us with exact specific direction and instructions. Kinsa may gusto mahitabo na. It's not impossible sa Ginoo. Amen. The more you hear His voice, the more nga God will direct you sa unsa man nga mga step ang dapat nimo lakwan. Amen. God can tell you know what, don't go this way, this is wrong, go this way, kani nga maagi imong dapat buhaton. God can do that for you kung kabalo lang ka maminaw. Sige. Unsa man so kani ana koy question, what conditions must be met in order for us to obey? So number 1 is we have to respond to God without any hesitation. James 1:5-8. So kani dinhi, James compares someone who doubts to a wave in the sea that is tossed around by the wind. They do not have an anchor to keep them grounded and as a result they become confused or unhappy or dissatisfied, especially when deciding whether or not to trust God. So naging yun din sa James 1:5-8 na ato dang basahon be, sige, pinapaspas daw, James. It says here, if you lack wisdom, unsa imong dapat buhaton, you should ask God. And He will give it to you generously. Amen. Thank you, Lord. To all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt. Because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do. So, kinahanglan nga unsa man, dili na to i-doubt ang word sa Ginoo. When God speaks, all we have to do is, Lord, naalang ko, Lord, mutuo ko sa imuhang word, Ginoo. Amen? Pero how many of us, dahan pa kita grason, you know, a million of reasons for us not to do one thing na gina-ask sa Ginoo. Tama? So, nagingon din hinga, if you lack, kung panahon nga, murag wala ka kabalo kung unsa ang imong buhaton, then ask the Lord. That's all. Pero how many of us, instead na mag-ask ka kay, have you seen somebody na nag-ask sila but they're not opening their mouth? Bata siguro, no? Anak, no? Pero God is asking us to speak, open your mouth. Diba? Naman tayo ba-ba? No? So if you lack, Lord, dili ko kabalo mag-desisyon ani Ginoo, please give me wisdom. Ayaw pod pag, kabalo na ko ani. Dili pod. Don't do things na dili pod will ni Lord. Okay? If you are unsure of what to do, ask. Pangayo lang. And God said, He will give it to you generously. So, number two, we need to put the word into action every day. Hala, every day na gyud ni ba? Okay? So, 1 Corinthians, okay. I believe na our relationship with God is a work in progress. Amen? That means we cannot stay as we are because we are no longer kids. Amen. Sige. Speaking and reasoning like one, but we are to put away childish things. Mao nang giingon dira sa 1 Corinthians na tanang mga binata nga mga butang because we're no longer 7-year-old. Diba? So dili na ta mga bata. So it simply means na we have to, this time we have to put God's word into action. Ato na siyang buhaton. Okay? So, James 1:22, nagingon din ni, do not merely listen to the word, so deceive yourselves. So, kung maingon ka na, naminom ako sa pulong sa Ginoo, pero wala ni mogi put into action, it says that you are deceiving yourselves. Imo lang gilinlang imuhang kaugalingon, o imo lang giatik imuhang kaugalingon. So kinahanglan nato nga buhaton, we have to do what it says. Okay? Why? Kay ang head knowledge is very dangerous. I tell you, daghan kaayo mga tao, Pharisees are so smart when it comes to memorizing and detalyado ginatanan na ilang mga ano. But God says, dili ko gusto nga bright kay mo din sa inyong una-una because I have met a lot of smart people but napay one time ana siya, dili na ko ma-feel ang gugma sa Ginoo and yet very smart siya. Bright siya academically pero how come dili ni mo masabtan, dili ni mo ma-feel sa imong kasing-kasing nga maayo ang Ginoo? Why? Because head knowledge is very, very dangerous. Amen. I'm not saying you don't have to be smart, but I'm saying dili na nato ibutang tanan ang kaalam nato sa atong ulo. Amen. Hikapa do imong heart be kung nagpitik pa na be. Let your heart listen and then ibutang sa imong kasing-kasing and then do it. Buhato nato. Amen? Amen. If God says give, buhatag ta. If God says love, then let's give love. Amen? Why? Because every time you sow something good, unsa may mahitabo, it will come back to you. Okay? Number three, we need to establish a higher value in confessing the word of God. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Sige, ang tanan nga nakasabot ani be, akong binisayon ha, kailangan nato na ma-establish, unsa may ma-establish atong kanang mapundar gyud sa atong kaugalingon ang pulong, kanang ikumpisal gyud ang pulong sa Ginoo, okay? One time When Lucas was 2 years old, nagtanaw ko sa bata, ako lang niya, ako lang ni, ako lang. It's not really the word of the Lord, it's just me, ha? So, I was looking at Lucas, mga 2 siya ato, tanaw ko sa iya, ha? Tas anak ko, kanta siya, the wheels on the bus go round and round. So, I was looking at him, sige siya kanta, wheels on the bus, anak ko na, murag, it's okay manaw mag wheels on the bus ko, pero what if i-convert ni na ako, siyang pamemorize sunog memory verse. Kay naisip na ako, ako lang niha, ayoko na yung ahok mira ko, ako lang. So naisip na ako, itry ko na ako na, instead of sige siya kanta, the wheels on the bus go round and round, 58 hours sig balik-balik ang wheels on the bus, mga flat na ginato mga wheels on the bus ba, kay 58 hours na dyan kayo niba. So what I did is, gikuha na ako ang Bible, nag-start ko sa restorya sa iya, ha. Hangtod na, dili lang ako makita ang video, but gipraktisan na ako siya, nag-start ko sa Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. So dula na po siya, wheels on the bus na po. Pagbalik niya sa ako, the Lord is my shepherd. Balik-balik. At 2 years old, Lucas can memorize Psalm 23. Wow. Tapos, anak ko, hala, nag-effect lagi ni. Galing, anak ko, wow. So, if you are young in the Lord, kung 1 year pa ka, sige lang, memory verse lang. The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. Kung di pa ka makalahutay sa next linya, it's okay. The Lord is my shepherd. Pag mag-gets na nanimo in a week, I shall not want. I shall not want. Pag next upon, He makes me to lie down in green pastures. So balik na po ka pa. Third week, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall lack nothing. He makes me to hangtod na mahuman dyan na nimo. Amen. So pila sa inyo ha karon din ang 10 years old na kay Lord. Ay na lang pataas kay basta may mga judgmental kay ko. Sige. So, nganong kailangan man, why do we need to establish that foundation? Nga ato yung ikumpisal ang pulong sa Ginoo. Simply because 100 more scriptures nag-ingon nga, need nato na basahon ang pulong sa Ginoo. Okay? Psalm 1, kasi nakabalo, Psalm 1, blessed is the one who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, and sit in the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the law of the Lord and who meditates on his law day and night. That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which shields its fruit and season, and on whose leaf does not wither. Whatever they do prospers. Not so the wicked. They are like chaff that the wind blows away. Therefore the wicked will not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the assembly of the righteous. For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked leads to destruction. Amen. Amen. If you wanna be blessed, you don't have anything, you don't have to do anything else but listen and obey and confess the word of the Lord. You don't have to strive. A lot of people, I've seen lots of people na they strive to be in a position. Gusto ko maging CEO, gusto ko maging director, or gusto ko maging reverend. You don't have to strive that. Nga naman, as you keep following the Lord, stepping, sikiglakaw sa mga pamalaod sa Ginoo, God will order things to you and God will put you in that place. Amen? Dili na ka kinahanglan nga mag-struggle ka. Yes, I believe in masteral doctorate, but dili na ba ang requirement ni Lord? So kung matarong ka igsoon, kung imong ginatamod ang pulong sa Ginoo, ibutang ka sa posisyon kung asa ka dapat ibutang. Amen? We don't have to strive for the position nga gusto dyan ko nga ako lang yun ang mahimong ingani. Gusto dyan ko nga maging tagiya dyan ko BDO. Just don't aim that one. Aim to obey the Lord. Walk with the Lord. Amen? And then everything will follow, right? Hallelujah. Sige, so na ako'y trivia sa inyo. Nganong dapat ginato ni tagaan og bili? Sige, ikaw daw be, let's say it. Establish, basa daw.
Establish a higher body when you confess in the word of God.
Sige, nag-google ko, Nag-ingon dito na everyday, kabalo ba mo nga? Wala. So, para sa mga nakabalo, quiet na lang sa. So, in a day daw, people can say 6,000 or 7,000 words. Kasi kabaloan na. I'm like, galing, 6,000. So, gihap-ihap na ako akong word, nag-practice ko. Oh my goodness. So, in a day daw, so according sa study, daghan mga studies, ingon sila, it's about 12 single spaced pages. Tapos, kana siya, mahitabo ko na ng 6 to 7,000 words in 20 minutes. So grabe ni gina to katabian no mo gina no wonder nga nagi mga marites kay 20 minutes surut na mo 6,000 words grabe 20 minutes imagine na nimo nya kita di ba okay na ani na pag iisa tapoy mga higher na mga studies nila ingon sila guess this ingon sila dinhi 16,000 words a day. Ingon siya, ang isa ka study na ingon siya nga 6 to 7,000 lang ang words every day, but another study says, no, it's not 6,000, it's 16,000. So kana siya, it's composed of 28 single spaced pages. So ano ko kapuyan na magiging mag one page, no, kung tabi, kaya ra. Pero kung sulat, 28. Tapos, it's roughly an hour to say it loud. Isa ka oras, 16,000 words. So, akong question. Imagine na ninyo na 6,000 words every day. So, akong question is, what is the quality of those words be like? Ooh, anak ko, oh my God, Lord, guilty ko, sorry, Lord, hindi na ako kaya, sorry na. So, unsa mga words kayo mong ginapaminaw? What voices are you listening? Because guess what? There are many voices. Natay madungog na mga voices. Mutuo mo, ana?
Yes.
Okay, sige. Tayo kong example, bes. Na naging og yes. Voices. Unsa mga voices kayo mong madungog? Facebook. Unsa pa?
Barkada.
Ha? Barkada. Unsa pa yun? Mama. O sige, kinsa pa? Maragol ba ning voice sa mama? Kay marag... okay. Ang papa no kay, di rin makina sila mo storya, marag kaisa laman, pero kulba po nilang voice. Okay, so... naay mga daghang voices nga itong mga madungog. The devil. Kinsa may mo agree, ana? Nga na i-voice ang devil, na itigog ang demonyo, di na ni mo kaya ikaw? Ha? Nga naman, tag-suroy, wama kay grado, ha? Unsa 75, nagay na yung grade, dili ka, wakay maabtan. Voices, tingog sa demonyo. Surroundings, mao na to, Facebook, FM, Super Balita, unsa pa ba? TikTok, grabe TikTok. So daghan kitag voices sa demonyo palang daan, ikaw palang daan, mismo ikaw, makadungog na ka nga, ha? Pagsuroy, di man ka, huwag man kay kaugmaon. Tingog sa demonyo, nag-entertain na ka. Pag-abli nimo sa imong cellphone, Facebook, puro lang mga... Dapat sexy ka, dapat taas kang ilong, dapat naakay kaya, dapat ingaani ka, dapat pasyonista ka, dapat sunod ka sa oso, surroundings. Okay? YouTube, imagination. So aside, ana, napagitay, tunguna-huna, aside sa demonyo nga nagbakak sa ato, napagitay, tunguna-huna nga, bitaw, tama, na tama, Jud. Kailangan Jud ka manigtiil, maningkaabot para Jud nga, mahimo Jud kang inganig Jud. Dapat na Jud kay sakyanan, nga ingani. Dapat na Jud kay balay sa ladislawa, na nag-fantasize na ka, nga unta, ingani, kadako akong balay, akong mansyon, and all that. Mga fantasies, voices, ay muhang, huna-huna. And another thing is our flesh. Diba? Atong unod. So, nagsimba-simba. Uy, akapuya, Jud. Uy, simba na po. Sige lang. Dahan kay excuse. Sige lang kay mag-grow. Maghihapon ko kang Lord kundi ko mag-church. I can still, you know, hear the Lord if I will not go to church. Flesh. Ang atong unod. Okay? Mapadayon pa ko. People around us, aside pag sa surroundings, aside pag sa Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, si Amir Sarfati. People around us. Katong especially kani mga close kana nato sa atong circle, di ba? Pwede ang asawa, pwede ba na? Pwede magstorya sa atong voice. It can be positive, negative. Okay. And lastly, ang tingog ni Lord. So si Lord, layo na kay sana kay nagana kayo kag nadong kaning si Lord nga. Okay, maghulat na lang ko dere. I'll just wait until you are ready to hear my voice. No? So, ang akong point someone. So akong anak ko ni Lucas, let's try to count how many words ang someone kaya mo siyang gememorize. Gusto mo makabalo? It's only 123 words. Psalm 23, 109. Psalm 91, 273. Depende sa version. So imagine mo ko imo nag-i-add around 500 lang. My God, you have 6,000 words. Unsa imong ginapaminaw? Unya, kani pag yung someone, di pag hindi mo ma-memorize 123 words. Am I condemning you? Dili. Ang akong buti pasabot is unsa imong ginapaminaw. So mauna nga, kung mag-memorize ka, mabalik-balik ni mo, the Lord is my shepherd. Hangtod na masakitan sa imong kasing-kasing. The Lord. Hala, ang Ginoo di ako magbalantay. Wala di magkulang sa ako. Hangtod na imo ginang mabutang. Mauna nga, tagaan ginato nag-value ang pag-confess sa pulong sa Ginoo. Despite the chaos we are experiencing, the struggle you are going through, the uncertainty, ang pagpaminaw sa pulong sa Ginoo, hearing the Lord's voice correctly, can completely transform our lives and situations. Hearing a word from the Lord can completely transform the worst problem nga imong ma-imagine. Kaminyuon man, sarili man nimo, it's hearing the word of the Lord, mo ni makatabang sa imuha, nga matransform ang sitwasyon, nga imong ginaatubang. If you are sick, unsa imong ginabuhat kung magsakit ka? Sige, tagay kong example, bay, kung nagsakit ka, Albert, unsa imong ginabuhat? Hala, tawa-tawa, sana tong tawa-tawa, masige dengue ko! Sige, aside sa tawa-tawa, Albert, ikaduhan ni mong ginabuhat unsa man. Okay, so ingon si Albert, ang una ko nung niyang buhat, pag not feeling well siya, unsa yung ginabuhat, tawa-tawa is the key. Tubig and medicine is the key. Gusto mo makabalo ko unsa akong first nga, nasabta na ako nga dapat natubuhaton. You wanna know? Okay, you wanna know? Okay, what I quick. Sa panahon na magsakit, kung magsakit ka, why not say, Lord, pinaagi sa imong mga labot sa cross, naghatag kagkaayuhan, Ginoo. God, I thank you, Lord, that by your stripes, I am healed. Salamat, Ginoo. I claim that healing, God, in Jesus' name. How about ing ana? Ay hata mangitag tawa-tawa. Amen? I'm not saying na magdili ta magmedicine. No, I'm saying is confess the word of God. Lord, salamat Ginoo. Nagingon ka, Lord, maghatag ikag kinabuhi. Lord, you said in your word you're gonna give me long life. Lord, kaayuhan akong gipangayo karon Ginoo. Salamat, Lord, that I'm gonna live with a healthy body. Salamat Ginoo, with a healthy soul. Thank you, God. Nga kung sa maning nagabother sa ako, Lord, in Jesus' name, I come against it. Any pain, God, I say no. Dili ka baka hilabos akong lawas in the name of Jesus. Amen. Instead of us thinking na mapacheck up na jud ko, grabe na gyud ni, unya gikalentura ra kate. Chill. Available layo pa kay SPMC, confess the word of God. Amen. So si Lucas, pag magkasakit siya, it's siya, Mom, I feel okay na. Why? Because I asked Jesus to help me. Wow. Amen! Dapat yung anak, yes, tawa-tawa is 100% very good. Pero 1,000% very good. Lord, salamat Ginoo sa imong kaayuhan, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And then, imong spirit, murag, thank you, Lord. Okay na dyan ko, Lord. If you are in financial trouble, the Lord knows exactly how to help you. Amen? So Albert, if you are in financial trouble, usa mong ginabuhat, Bert? Tell me. Ha? Mohilak sa Ginoo, kanang dili pa ka mohilak sa Ginoo. Unsay mo mauna-unaan? Mangutang na lang siguro ko ka Ate Jeanette, or hala ka ni si Vidal ka engineer. Daghan kay ni commission ba, or dahan kay ni racket ba? Igsoon, Lord, salamat Ginoo that you are my provider. You are my Jehovah Jireh God. Thank you Lord that in you I'm not gonna lack any good thing in Jesus' name. Amen. The more sige tagtanog tao, the more nga dili maka-work si Lord sa atong behalf. Naara tanan, friends, mga fairson, naara jud tanan din eh. Okay? If you are financially dili man ka okay, God, tabangi ko Ginoo, give me godly ideas, God, how to make these things work, Ginoo. I need your help, God. I don't know what to do, Lord. I need you, Lord, help me. And I tell you, I've experienced mga panahon nga wajun may pagkaon. One time the Lord told me na bago lang ako na-receive akong allowance. So pag church na ako, God said, Monette, I want you to give everything na nasa imong pocket. So akong isip, my goodness, bago lang man akong allowance. So dugay kayo na, nagpila na sila, naghatag na sila, nagmano ko, Lord, ako mo, chong allowance. So niyana ko sa Ginoo, atras ko, Lord, kanang pwede ko magbilin og 7 pesos pamasahi lang, Lord, para pauli sa akong boarding house. And you know what? Yes, sakit man, pero anak ko, Lord, I trust you, Lord, I trust you. So niuli ko sa balay nga, walay pa ni Odo, gutom na kay ko, na ako'y bugas, pero hurot na akong ano, akong mga tanan ng mga dilata and all. Crew. So anak ko, laka Lord, alas 5 na Lord, gutom na kay ko Lord. All of a sudden, at 6 o'clock, na nanuktok. Kasi kami nuktok karon, namingaw man, kay Sunday. Pag-abli na ako, akong friend. Ang dili siya ka makatuo, nga nagdala siya rice, chicken, fruits, and dessert. The only thing na akong gitanaw is siya. Because knowing her, di gito mang libre nga classmate, grabe! Negosyante to siya, pero mayamanin akong classmate, pero grabe te, di gito mang libre. Pila na may kado, small libre ba yun? Kaya negosyante lagi. So kabalo mga kasi mga classmate, kaya mong kanang dikit-dikitan, grabe di gito mang libre. But you know what? When I look at her, ana, ang impress ni Lord sa ako, Monette, I can do the impossible. Even sa mga tao nga expect ni mo nga, ha? Siya, kakuripot ato, gigamit ni Lord just for you. Amen. Gikuha na ako ang food, ni ano ko, thank you. Gisira na ako akong pultahan. Inko Lord, pagka nawala akong kagutom. Inko Lord, grabe ka kamaayo Lord. Even ang pinakasimple na mga butang, God can do it for you. Yes. Amen. Matuo mo, ana. Sige. Oh, thank you, Jesus. So this time I wanna challenge everybody nga kung feeling nimo na amang kay kana bitong ginaatubang nga sitwasyon nga murag lisod gani kasi mo murag ingani ka gahi ba na maski iuntog nimo imong ulo murag gosh kalisod sa sitwasyon. But you know what, na isong na nagingonen siya nga God can still move mountains. Amen. God can still heal the sick people. Amen. Muto mo ana. Hallelujah. God can still do miraculous things. Nga naman, kay the Bible says nga mahanaw ang tibuok kalibutan, ang pulong sa Ginoo, the word of God will remain. I tell you mga igsoon, sa atong sitwasyon karon, challenge is, gera is everywhere, war after war, chaos after chaos. You know what can unsay makapadlig, unsay imuha, what can make you stand? Di lang imuhang kwarta, di lang imuhang pagka-doctorates, but ang pulong sa Ginoo nga mo'y magmulahutay jud ka ani nga panahon. Muna ka gina-challenge kita mo karon na please, atong i-intune ang atong dalungan sa Ginoo, because Hapit na mo balik si Lord, and if only kitang tanan isa-isa sa atua kanang inchon lang gyud diha sa Ginoo, kitang tanan magka-unite, I believe daghan jud kay kahimuan si Lord. There's gonna be a lot of things na pwede buhaton si Lord, dili lang para sa imong sarili nga satisfaction, pero para sa mga tao, sa mga naa sa gawas. Amen. Not just for you, but for others who needs the Lord. Amen. And I want you, I encourage you, kung wala pa mo'y memory verse, get one. Kung wala mo'y, kung dili mo gusto'y memory verse, i-challenge yung kaugalingon. Lord, gusto ko Ginoo mag-memorize og isa ka chapter. Amen. Atong i-challenge atong kaugalingon, because this is the only way nga makabarog ta sa panahon sa trouble. The Bible says God can be with you in trouble, pero the only way nga makastand ka in trouble, if He is with you. Amen. If you acknowledge nga, Lord, you are my refuge, you are my shield, oh God, and nothing can harm me. Amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus.